The prosecution wasted no time in getting right to the heart of where they see this case. With Sandusky sitting at the defense table, lead prosecutor Joe McGettigan called the Second Mile, the charity that Sandusky founded, quote, a perfect environment for a predatory pedophile. McGettigan said Sandusky systematically sought out the most vulnerable of children in the Second Mile, at times keeping a list of names of Second Mile children and leaving notations next to those names of how many parents were in the household, and sometimes even the children's shoe size and hair color to keep track of them. McGettigan also showed a slideshow of the accusers to the jury. This is the first time the jurors have seen who these accusers are, and the pictures were when the accusers were children at the time of the alleged incidents. McGettigan went through each of the 8 children, calling them by their first name and telling the jurors stories about the alleged abuse that the jurors will hear through the course of this case. He also made a reference to the first witness who will take the stand once opening statements are over, and that's going to be accuser number 4. McGettigan said Sandusky drew up some sort of contract with accuser 4 that dealt with how much time the two should spend together. Apparently, according to McGettigan, Sandusky wanted to spend even more time than accuser 4 was willing to give him, so they wrote out this contract so Sandusky would be guaranteed time with accuser 4. Throughout the opening statements, which lasted about 50 minutes for the prosecution, Sandusky was sitting at the defense table, not reacting much to what was going on. Now what happens is Joe Amendola, the defense attorney, will have his time to make his opening statements before the first witness is called.